Hey guys, Corey Webster here. I got a short little video, and I'm passionate about this subject very much, especially for my own game. But what the thing is basically you can't swing too flat. You can swing too steep, but you can't swing too flat. The only reason swinging too flat would ever hurt you is if you open the club face. If you don't open the club face, so if I swing flat and I open the club face, well, yeah, someone would say you're swinging too flat, but I'm opening the club face. The club face is opening, so yeah, that would be a problem. But what if I don't open the club face? Can I swing too flat? Well, I don't think so. And I've got some proof at the end of this, which is another player who swings the flattest I've ever seen, and it proves the point, which is why I'm going to show you that video. But if I take it in one hand, and if the face stays square to the target line, I keep going. So at this point, I fully transferred my weight onto my right leg. Now, the only way for me to keep the club going back would either be to keep it going back with my arm, or to keep turning my shoulders. So if I'm standing here and I rotate my shoulders to there, if I were to put a club in my hand and my main objective was to not move my arm or the club and just rotate my shoulders, and then now if I go, because the club didn't open, right? So why would it not come back to the ball square if I never opened it? And if all I've done is coiled my shoulders, then it would appear that I have a flat swing because I never lifted the golf club up. The only reason my golf club would ever go up is if I lift it. Because if I don't lift it, why would it go up? I would have to have like a really steep shoulder angle or time, I'd have to tilt my spine a lot and have it go up. But if I come up just kind of naturally like this and just rotate my shoulders, I'm going to have a flat swing. So if you had absolutely no lift in your swing with your arms whatsoever, you would have a very flat swing. And I'm going to show you a video of that right now. Okay, so amazing, right? Well, at least I think so. So if you had flatter lie angles and you worked on not lifting your arms and just swinging as far as rotating your shoulders without lifting, just swing a little smoother so that I can actually hang on to the golf club. I'm not quite strong enough to do it with one hand, but if I set it up with two, so I'm gonna come back, same thing. So if I come into the camera and I sit here like this, now I'm set up to hit a golf ball, okay? Try to get the angle right. So I'm set up to hit a golf ball right here. Now, if I literally just coil my shoulders and keep my hands in this position, and now come back. That'd be a decent position, right? So let's try, I'll try two in a row. So coil my shoulders, no lift. Try one more. Coil my shoulders, no lift. That was a good one. So you can't swing too flat. And the reason why is because when you take the club away, you don't need to lift it. So if you don't lift it, your swing would look flat. But if you don't open the face, you're gonna be good to go. And we've been talking a lot about feeling the shaft. Well, this is a great way to feel it. Because you come back, boom, you've got it, you're feeling the shaft, boom, right there. So your swing can be super easy and a lot simpler. I mean, you look at a Mo Norman, his swing looked different, but it was really, really simple. It was really effective. And if you're gonna play golf, you need an effective swing. If you're gonna just sit on the range and look beautiful, well then you can work on your swing and have it look however you want, but it's not always the best way to compete and play under pressure. And by under pressure, you could have someone like me that's trying to play for a living, or someone that is playing for a living, they've got a pressure, you know. Sometimes a couple $100,000 is on the line, or maybe even more, maybe their whole career if they're close to losing their card. But if you take someone that plays two rounds of golf a year and their boss invites him out, they've got pressure to not make a fool of themselves. So everyone has pressure, and that pressure affects you, affects your heart rate, everything. So by feeling the shaft, you can feel the shaft to hit a shot, which will take the pressure off you and what you have to do, because you can just feel it in the shaft. And by not lifting your arms up, so by coming back and not getting here and then lifting your arms up, right? That would be just this move right here. Well, if I don't ever do that in my swing, I'm right there. I got the shaft, boom. So, hope that helps and give it a try. And I hope you like the video of my friend swinging there. I can't pronounce his name. It's like Ho Kyum or whatever like that. But I'll leave a link in the comments to where you can find this guy on YouTube. He's got his own channel. I just can't pronounce his name. All right, peace, guys.